Today the media labels, the media says that Muslims are terrorists. What is the meaning of the word terrorist? A terrorist by definition means a person who causes terror. When a robber sees a policeman, he's terrified. So for the robber, the policeman is a terrorist. And many times we see that for the same person, for the same activity, two different labels are given. And the best example is when India was ruled by the British government about more than 60 years ago, there were many Indians who were fighting for the freedom of the country. These people, by the British government, they were called as terrorists. But we common Indians, we call these people as patriots, as freedom fighters. Same people, same activity, but two different labels. If you agree with the view of the British government that they had a right to rule over India, then you have to call these people as terrorists. But if you agree with the view of the common Indians that the Britishers came to India to do business, they have no right to rule over us, you would call these people as patriots, as freedom fighters. Same people, same activity, but two different labels. And many a times, when I'm addressing the Indian press, and they ask me the question, that why are Muslims terrorists? So I ask them a question, that more than 65 years ago, the Britishers called Bhagat Singh as a terrorist. Do you believe? And the press says no. I say, why? No, because we know that Bhagat Singh was not a terrorist, he was a patriot. I said, even I do not agree that Bhagat Singh was a terrorist. He was a patriot. 60 years back when the Britishers labeled Bhagat Singh as a terrorist, you don't agree with him. Now when the Britishers are labeling Muslims as terrorists, why do you agree with them? Why these double standards? And we have this example in history in several places in the world. We know that a couple of centuries back, Britishers used to rule America. In 1776 was the American Revolution. At that time, there were many Americans who were fighting for the freedom of the country. And at that time, the British government called George Washington as terrorist number one. Terrorist number one in 1776, according to the British government, was George Washington. When USA gets its freedom, terrorist number one becomes the president of USA. We have example of South Africa. Previously, when the white apartheid government ruled South Africa, they arrested Nelson Mandela and imprisoned him in Robben Islands for more than 25 years. And they called him the terrorist number one. When South Africa got its freedom, the same terrorist number one becomes the president of New South Africa. And later on, he gets the Nobel Prize for Peace. Not that he was bad and he became good. For the same activity for which he was called terrorist number one, later on, he gets the Nobel Prize for Peace. Can you imagine terrorist number one in the world getting Nobel Prize for Peace? So what we realize, that whoever is in power, whatever label is given, it gets stuck, whether right or wrong. So today media is very powerful. Whatever label the media gives, unfortunately, it gets stuck, irrespective whether it's right or wrong.